Hello everyone, here we come up with a third video where we are going to update a database. Now I have already inserted a values into a database in the last video. I have inserted a three records, that is ID, name, salary is a columns heading, and 1, 2, 3 is the records with names Raj, Rahul and Mehul with their prospective salaries. Now in this video I am going to update a salary of a employee, that is Rahul, of 20,000 into a Rahul of 29,000. Now I will update the salary of 20,000 into a 29,000 of a employee Rahul. Now how to do that? I already explained you how to take a connector, how to connect using a connect class, and how to use a cursor. Let's see one more time what is mysql.connector. You have to import this mysql.connector package. First you have to install a connector, mysql connector of an Python, then only you can import this package. So import space mysql.connector, this will connect mysql with a Python IDLE by using a connect class, mysql.connector.connect. Host is a local host where MySQL and Python will be on a single PC. User is root. User is Praveen, it must be, and password is root. So now what is this username and password? This is a username and password of a MySQL where you have to mention here, and the database that we have created in a first video, that is DB. So this is how the connect class will connect all this with a MySQL. That is, Python is connected with a MySQL. This will be stored in a variable called MyDB. Though MyDB will have a connection of a Python and a MySQL. Now, what is cursor? I have explained you. Cursor will traverse whatever the commands or a queries you are going to give in your program. So, what is my command or query here? Update command or a query. Let's see this update query. Before that, MyDB dot, I am whatever the cursor I am going to perform, that is whatever the query I am going to execute, that will be implemented on a MyDB, that is database. So all this connection will be in a MyDB. So MyDB will execute a cursor, that these two will be stored in a variable called cur. So cursor method that will be implemented on a my database will be stored in a cur variable. Now what is this s variable? S variable will have a command, that is the query is update. I am going to update employee table, that is table name. Set is a keyword. What it will set? Salary 29,000. It will set a salary to a 29,000 where ID is equal to 2. Wherever the ID number is 2, it will set a 20,000 salary into a 29,000. That is an update command I have given. This command will be stored in a variable called yes. So now this command must be executed by using a cursor, because cursor will execute this queries by using a cur variable. So cur dot execute in bracket yes. Yes is a command or query that I have given in a yes variable. So cursor cur will execute this command. After executing this command, the changes must be done is where execution is different, but changes must be done in a MyDB, because whatever I am doing a changes, whatever the program working procedure will be done, that changes will be implemented in a MyDB, because mysql.connector.connect is given in a MyDB variable. So mydb.commit command is a command which will execute your query. So this is how your data will be updated. But what you have to do now is go for a MySQL, select star from employee, execute this query. You will see before executing this query the data will be 20,000 of a Rahul. After executing this update command, then you will get an 29,000. Before this video, in a second video you have seen the Rahul salary is 20,000, but after update it will be a 29,000. So this is how a simple single command or a query will change all your program. If you want to do a delete any record from the table, that will be shown in the next video, will be done here. So yes, variable will take your commands and execute using an execute command and make changes using an commit command. So this is how update will be done in a database. Thank you.